Hey, what's going on, guys? This video here is going to be from the vault, revolver safety. I was actually looking through my external hard drive and I found this footage here that was probably recorded back in 2013. I've been finding a lot of different footage I never used. So I was watching this video here and I thought this was pretty cool. So hopefully you'll get something out of this. And showing you in this video are two different 686s. We got a 686 competitor model above from the Performance Center. That one actually had a cracked frame. You can go back to my videos about that. I got rid of it after I got it back from Smith. I just didn't trust the thing. So I sold it to, somebody. The one below is the snub nose 686 with a 2.5-inch barrel. And I carried that thing a lot. I don't own that one either anymore. Actually sold that one as well, and I do regret it. I think the 686 2.5-inch barreled revolver is a classic, and I think it's just a really cool snub-nose revolver, and I got to get one of those back. My buddy actually has the 686 Plus Performance Center, and it's a sweet revolver. He really puts some rounds through that thing. Like, he really uses that thing. And it's a phenomenal revolver, so I do miss the 686 2.5-inch barrel 357 Magnum snub nose. Back on track here, this video here, like I said, is from the vault, revolver safety, so check it out. Hope you enjoy it, and let me know what you think. All right, here we go. Hey, what's up, guys? This video here, I want to talk about revolver safety. And what I mean by revolver safety is hand position, gripping a revolver. Because when I pick up, say, one of my 1911s, my Beretta, my SIG, my Glock, or one of my M&Ps, and back in the day, when I was being trained on one of those, I was always taught the thumbs forward grip. That was the only way to shoot that gun. It was a thumbs forward grip, using this type of grip. Now, with the revolver, however, I was always taught to shoot a revolver using a thumbs locked grip in this fashion right here, okay? And there's a reason for that, right? You guys know this. There is a gap, slight gap right there, the barrel cylinder gap, where gases escape and come out. You know, pressure and gas and all that, flame. So it would be ill-advised to put any digits, okay, in front of the cylinder. And you guys know that. And I want to tell you a little situation that happened to me recently at the shooting range. Now, this revolver right here always attracts attention. It's amazing. When I pull this revolver out at the shooting range, it never fails. Someone comes up to me and says, "What is that? I got to look at that. Oh man, that looks so cool. Can I shoot it?" And I say, sure. But it's getting to the point that every single person wants to shoot this thing. But anyways, this guy that was at the range actually had a Nighthawk Custom Chris Costa model. Very nice 1911. And he saw me pull this thing out, and he's like, "Whoa." He's like, "Can I look at that?" And I'm like, "Yeah, sure." And he's checking it out. He's like, "Do you mind if I shoot it? I'll let you shoot a mag full of, you know, 45 out of my Chris Costa 1911, you know, Nighthawk. And can I shoot 6 rounds of 357 out of your really cool revolver here?" And I said, "Yeah, that sounds fair." And he's like, "I want to shoot the hottest magnum loads you got in that range bag." And I was like, "Well, that would have to be the Underwood 125 grainers." So, okay. So I load them up in the cylinder, okay. And I shut it up like that for him, you know, being very safe at the on the line. And I knew that, you know, the guy's got a ultra expensive 1911, you know, Chris Costa, Nighthawk Custom Signature Model 1911. So I know the guy's probably got some good experience under his belt. That's what I'm thinking. But I ask him anyways, "Have you ever fired a revolver?" And he's like, "Oh yeah." He's like, "I mean, I don't own a revolver, but I've fired a few. My friend has an Alaskan that's a 44 Magnum." He's like, "I fired that thing." So I'm thinking, "Oh, okay, all right." But I stand there anyways. I don't go out into the other port and start shooting his Nighthawk Custom. I just wanted to just watch him, you know. I'm just sitting there watching him. I feel, you know, that's my responsibility at least. Even though I think he's probably, you know, a shooter and what have you. So I see him pick this revolver up. He's like picking it up. He's like, "All right, all right." He's going like this. He's like, "Ugh." I'm like, "Whoa, whoa." I'm like, "Hey, hey, what are you doing?" He's like, "What?" And I'm like, hold it a second there, hold it. I'm like, why are you gripping the revolver like that? Whoa, whoa. And he's like, what are you talking about? And I tell him, do you realize that there's a blast, okay? The barrel cylinder gap here, there's going to be a huge blast coming right out of there. And he was looking at me funny, and he's like, I don't know. I don't understand what's going on, because other people were shooting. So I said, all right, let's make safe, okay? Let's put it back down the, you know, on the table here. And I took out all the ammo, and he was trying to tell me, he's like, well, the reason why I was holding it, you know, gripping it like that was because, he's like, the barrel's so freaking heavy, you know, and I was trying to support it, you know, by doing this, by putting his thumb right in this groove right here, and he was gonna about do this. Guys, do I have to tell you what would happen if he fires an Underwood 125 grain 357 Magnum in this position like this? Also, having his thumb like this could screw up the cylinder because, look, he's moving it. I mean, so, I don't even want to do that. But imagine if someone's thumb was, like, right there and they fired a 357 Magnum round that comes out of here at 1,600 feet per second. That Underwood stuff is no joke. The blast, the sound, I mean, wow, it's very, very impressive. When I fire that stuff at the range, everybody stops what they're doing. The freaking range master thinks it's a 44 mag, and he's like, whoa, that better not be 44 Magnum. I'm like, no, read it and weep, okay? All right, read that. But that's how impressive Underwood ammunition is. It's like, wow. But it's obvious that this individual didn't know what he was doing, but he didn't understand the manual of arms or an operation of a revolver. I am glad that I stood there right behind his back and watched him. I don't even want to think about what would have happened if that round did go off. I mean, his palm was against the cylinder, so he was probably, you know, once that hammer was coming back, it moves. But anyways, so we stopped the potential accident from happening there. And it just goes to show, guys, if you do go to the shooting range and you meet somebody there that wants to shoot your Glock, shoot your Beretta, you know, shoot your revolver, it is our responsibility just to make sure everything, you know, is safe. And to be aware that maybe this person may not be telling you the full truth. They're just telling you a line just, you know, because they're embarrassed, maybe, that they don't really understand what a revolver is or whatever. So that's all I really wanted to share with you guys. I thought that was, I mean, I was really, like, nervous when I saw that. I was gonna about to just, like, grab him. You know, I almost did, but luckily he heard me. He just got his finger out of the trigger, and we avoided an accident. So, all right, guys, tell me what you think. Leave some comments, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.